Hi everybody, my name is Jenny, and today is a little bit more of a serious matter. I shouldn't be touching my face or messing with my hair on camera. Too bad. Today I'm going to talk about what it is to be transgender, because I feel like this might be helpful for some people. A lot of this I've done previously in a Let's Play, like what I'm about to say now. Minecraft. Like when I came out, I was like, okay, I'm coming out. Here's everything you need to know about it. My phone's going off. Do I grab my phone? No, I'm gonna wait. I'll leave it alone. I have ADHD. Ignore me. So I'm gonna read a little bit of the Wikipedia article for it, and then I'll explain some of it, like from a personal standpoint. My views, thoughts, and opinions and experiences do not reflect what it is to be transgender for everybody. I can only just do my best to try to generalize it without being like, well, we're all like this, because we're not. Everybody's experience is different when it comes to being transgender. Some people, we'll get there. I'll just read. From the Wikipedia article, transgender people are people who have a gender identity or gender expression that differs from their assigned sex. Now, of course, assigned sex being you're born, you need to put something on a birth certificate, so they usually get a quick look at you and be like, male, female. Usually simple enough for, I would say, a good portion of the population, it's simple enough. And then, of course, there are people like me, where I was assigned male at birth, and clearly that did not work out. Now, my own experience was that at a very, very young age, I did not want to be male. Like, since I was like 4 years old, I already knew. And it's something that just kind of, it simmers up, especially back then, because I'm 31. Back then you didn't have internet, or at least not quite as prevalent as we do now, and you couldn't just go online and look stuff up. You couldn't be like, ooh, what is transgender? No, it was, back then that kind of stuff was harder to find out. Like, you either experienced it through some other media outlet at the time, TV or books. What's up with my throat all of a sudden? Thanks, that stupid candy. Like, for me, it was especially books, because for me, it like simmered up to a point where I was like, okay, something is wrong with me. I didn't want to say it was wrong with me, but something is not right about me. So I went to the big library downtown in San Antonio and literally like started searching, like, I want to be a girl and stuff like that, and books about being transgender would come up, and I was like, holy crap, that's a thing. And then of course it just goes and goes from there. But that's my very, very simplified personal experience. I will also go into some of the other parts of that, because some of this stuff could confuse people. Transgender people are sometimes called transsexual if they desire medical assistance to transition from one sex to another. Transgender is also an umbrella term in addition to including people whose gender identity is the opposite of their assigned sex, myself. It may include people who are not exclusively masculine and feminine, just people who just don't mind and just go back and forth. Stuff like that, gender fluid. Let's not get too complicated. Another definition of being transgender is that it can also include a third gender that's more in tune with like the Native American Two-Spirit, because it's not, you're not really one or the other, you're more like both at the same time, and that can, that's included in this definition. And of course, Crossdressers are sometimes included in that. That's usually personal preference. I don't mind it as long as it's more prevalent. If you're just doing it for like sexual stuff, then you just have a kink, and it's not. No. But yeah. Usually, like from old school experience. Like I consider myself transgender, even though I've clearly had some medical assistance to transition. I'm on hormones. These are real. No implants. And transsexual would be more along the lines of actually having like this physical operations for changing your genitals, getting like facial restructuring, breast implants, stuff like that. And some people take it as an insult, but I don't. I mean, it's just another word for the same thing. So, just stick with transgender. If you're not sure what to call somebody, stick with transgender. Or just trans, because nobody's going to care. And, of course, being transgender is independent of sexual orientation. Transgender people may identify as heterosexual, homosexual, bisexual, asexual. There's everything sexual in the millions of words. It's insane now, because it's... There's, like, a sexual for everything. Not to judge, but it's kind of ridiculous at times. I personally identify as bisexual. Although it's mostly due to still some kind of confusion with me, because the first person I became attracted to and fell in love with and had a relationship with was female. We were both teenagers at the time, and nothing ever really came of it. It just sort of faded away after a while. It wasn't like a breakup. There wasn't any bad feelings. We just kind of lost track of each other and stopped talking up until recently. And then some of the biggest loves of my life have been male. Like, just completely straight up. I will use the term cisgender. I won't explain it yet, but cisgender male. Like, the guy I'm currently interested in. I hope I'm not blushing. I hope I have enough makeup on to hide that. And then, of course, there is my now ex-wife. Another transgender person. And, yeah, it's how complicated it can get. But I guess I'll explain cisgender real quick. Cisgender applies to anybody who is just the one gender. Born male, you're male, you're happy with it. Good for you. That's what that means. It's not meant to be an insult or anything usually. It's just to differentiate between being transgender, me, and just normal without being insulting to myself. And another thing to have to explain, this is a big part. Man, my throat. Stupid sugary candy. Hold on. Okay. One of the things that is a major component in being transgender or transsexual is gender dysphoria. Now, I'm not going to try to explain everybody's experience with it, but the easiest way for me to sum up like mine is, I have a mirror here on the wall, so I'm kind of pointing at it, but you can't see it. When I don't have makeup or anything, and I look like crap, like I do sometimes in my videos, and I'm all covered up, and I basically just look like a guy, when I see myself like that in the mirror, you have to imagine looking in the mirror and not knowing who that is. Like everybody has a mental image of themselves. Like when you dream or when you imagine things, how you see yourself. Imagine that not lining up with what you see in the mirror. Because that's what that is for me. And it can be for lack of a better word, because I shouldn't be using the same word in the definition for it. It can be dysphoric. What would be the word? Confusing. Frightening. It's not knowing who you are. And it's really, really tough to deal with some days. Like, I'll wake up. I have to avoid mirrors when I wake up for quite some time, unless I'm ready to, like I've already, like, shaved, because I do it in the shower completely based on touch, because I cannot look at myself. If I feel like I look bad. And the only thing you can do about that kind of thing is learn how to deal with it. And the dysphoria is why we take medical steps toward becoming who we feel we are. For me, that was hormone replacement therapy, because it helps me, like, my body is actually fairly feminine. You can't see because I'm all like shoulders up here, but part of what I see for myself requires a more shapely body, and hormones are helping with that quite a bit. I mean, when I wear the right things, I look really good, and then of course I look like crap 90% of the time. That 10%, that's me. And yeah, it's incredibly difficult for that kind of thing, because, like, especially here in the United States, we don't have, like, public access to these things. You have to go through, well, up until very recently, you used to have to go through a very complicated process of psychotherapy, and then, I don't remember all the steps for it. I'll kind of try to summarize. Matt can probably correct me, I'm sure. He probably knows it better than I do, because he's a freaking doctor and wants to be a psychiatrist. You start with therapy. They assess you, like, okay, you're transgender, let's go up. Then they made you have real life experience. You had to go out, you had to live your life as the sex you wanted to be for a whole year before being allowed to have hormones. And for a lot of people, that does not work. Like, you can be transgender and look awful, like, from your starting point. Like, if I wasn't any decent at it now, I have such bad, like, facial scarring from, like, acne, and I have really bad, like, facial hair shadow. And for a lot of us, that can just make it worse. Like, trying to figure out what to do, because, I mean, now we have the internet, and it's fairly simple. You just look up makeup tutorials and stuff, but back in the mid-90s, trying to do that, it was rough. Like, you're basically on your own. And then, after a year of that, then you're allowed hormones. And then after a year of hormones, you're allowed to have various medical procedures done, if you so choose. That last part is still true. They make you do hormones for a year in a lot of places before allowing any kind of medical, or not medical, obviously, any kind of surgical, procedures to make yourself more feminine, like if you want breast implants. Obviously, for some reason, transgender people, like myself, if I wanted to go get breast implants, I'd basically have to prove that I actually need them for something. Whereas, of course, a normal cisgender woman can just be like, okay, give me breast implants, here's money. It's like, well, what? I want that too. And then, of course, the whole, in America, you have to pay for, unless you're on some kind of public assistance, you basically have to pay for a lot of this stuff. Unless you go the old school route, where they deem it medically necessary for you to do these things. And that's the physical end of that. Now, of course, there is the socioeconomic parts of this where, like I was saying, we don't have access to healthcare that we need in a lot of places. The big ongoing issue in the United States right now is whether or not we can even use the bathroom that we need to be using. Where I'm from, Texas, is trying to pass a bill right now that'll become a law. Hopefully not, but it probably will. It's freaking Texas. Where somebody, even looking like me, I have breasts and makeup and long hair, and I think I look feminine. Somebody looking like me would not be able to use the women's bathroom simply because my birth certificate has an M on it for gender or sex or whatever the hell it says. And this is even, like, once I get my license updated, even if that says F, if my birth certificate still has the M, that's what they want to go by. It's like, holy shit, they make it impossible to even use a toilet. And they've done this under the guise of that we're just perverts looking to look at people in the restroom, like under the stalls or something. And I'm just like, no, I don't want to do that, and I don't want anybody doing that to me. That's creepy as hell. Especially with, I don't have any operations yet, so I don't want anybody looking at me, like, at all. Even now, I'm like, no. No, leave me alone. Yeah, it's so stupid. I mean, I don't go to the bathroom for anything other than to go to the bathroom. In, out. That's it. I'm not going to be looking at people. I'm not going to be talking to people. Because my voice isn't the best. I don't even want to talk to anybody because it'll be a pretty damn good giveaway. And it's just, it's fucking ridiculous. Excuse the language, but it is. It's, what business is it of anybody's? What's between my legs? And what bathroom I'm using. And then, of course, that's just, they seem to have targeted transgender women with that. But then what about transgender men? A lot of them look really, really male. Like, testosterone works quite a bit more effectively than estrogen, as far as its intended purposes. Like, these guys are, like, built, and they have, like, full-on, like, goatees and beards, and it's just like, wow. You want to make him go to a woman's bathroom. You have fun with that. That's going to be awkward for everybody involved. Even worse than with transgender women, honestly. Because that's really obvious. Because even if I have to go to a male restroom, a lot of times guys will just be really confused by it. I've had to do that a couple times, although it's been accidentally. Not like I've walked into the wrong restroom, but apparently even when I, like, try to make myself, like, look kind of male now, I'm having a hard time with it because, like, my hair is kind of really, really feminine. And I'll have finished with the restroom and I'm standing there, like, washing my hands, and a guy will walk in. He'll get, like, two steps in the door, stop, look at me, look at the door, look at me again, and then walk out. Like, he thinks he's in the wrong restroom because he sees a woman in there. And I'm just like, oh my god, time to go. And I run away. And that happened a lot in Denver. Mostly because I'm not 100% comfortable using a women's restroom, because that's worse for me than trying to use a men's one. Like, basically, if a woman decides that I'm in there trying to be a pervert, that'll be, like, cops involved and stuff. Whereas guys, they'll just be like, okay, that's awkward, get the hell out of here. And yeah, it's a lot worse for transgender men with the whole restroom situation, because that's just, it's not going to end well. And then, of course, there's the matter of even just legal protections. It's becoming more and more prevalent, there is, but it used to be that if you're transgender, you were not protected. Just, they could fire you from your job just for being transgender. And it's like, why? Why can't you just leave me alone? What does it matter? I work. You give me money. That should be it. But no, they can, like, bring in their, like, their personal preferences and just do whatever the hell they want with you. It's mostly a matter of, like, places where you have to wear a uniform. Like, they will just, like, if you're transgender and you're working there, they will not let you, like, me, in a lot of places, I'm not allowed to wear a women's uniform, despite, like, hey, I have freaking curves and I look like a girl. For some reason, they think that's inappropriate. Whereas, I find it more inappropriate to be trying to dress like a guy, because I do not look good in anything other than, like, I could probably pull off, like, a three-piece or a five-piece suit. That'd actually look pretty cool, but... it's mostly just super awkward to even try to hold a job. Because, of course, anything retail or customer service based is going to make you have, like, a name tag. And Jennifer, Jenny, is not yet my legal name. So I end up with a name tag with a male name on it. And people are just like, And I'm just like, just, what do you want? Leave me alone. And it can be just generally, it makes things worse for everybody involved. Of course, because the area where I'm in now, New England, is a little bit strange on it, as far as I'm concerned. They don't seem to care, which is odd to me. I guess with Massachusetts, they've been dealing with this kind of thing for a decade or two now, as opposed to places like Colorado or Texas, where they're just, like, even realizing I exist. Because here, even if I try just a little bit to look feminine, people are just like, okay, female. I'm just like, okay, cool. And whereas in Colorado or Texas, I can only go based on places I've lived, obviously. They'll like kind of give you this, like they're thinking about it or something, like I'll look like this and still get called sir in those places just because of my voice. And it's just like, you know what, whatever you want. And then I just order my shit and leave and then never go back. And it's just, it's kind of ridiculous in a lot of ways. Just being transgender is insanely difficult. And it's now becoming like a legal issue, like I was saying, where are we even allowed to do things? Are we just, right now we're second class citizens. And it sucks. For anybody watching this who might be using this as some kind of information for, like, if they have, like, a transgender kid and they want to know what it's like, just let me tell you, it is, for one, it is not by choice. I would not choose this for myself or wish this on anybody. It is the most awful thing you could ever go through. You'll have to deal with years of misery and pain, and nobody is choosing this. If you think your kid is just being weird or just wants to be different, no. If they're saying they're transgender, assuming they know anything about it, make sure they're informed as well. Let them know everything they're going to have to do to get what they want. If they still want it, they probably really are transgender, because it is an awful experience. And I wouldn't wish it on anybody. And like, I know with me, now I'm trying not to cry at this too. For me, it's a matter of acceptance. I'm just now personally at 31 years old, because I basically ran away from San Antonio 2 years ago. I'm just now starting to, like, come out to my family, basically. Despite having been this way for... I've purposely and intentionally, like, started being feminine just, like, 5 or 6 years ago. Whereas... I've known since I was 4, so it was just, like, 20 years of torture of not being able to be who I knew I was. And I ran away because I didn't run away, but I left. I mean, I'm an adult, I can't run away. I left because I didn't think they were going to accept it at all. Shit, my damn nail polish. And I'm past that. I'm just now getting past it. Where I feel like whether or not they're going to accept it, I want them to know and let them make that choice instead of me just being, well, my family's dead to me because I'm transgender and I can't handle them rejecting me. I'm at the point where I want them back in my life. I want my family back. And so again, if you have a kid and they're transgender, just be there for them. They're not telling you to, like, help them with it necessarily, or that they want to, like, rub it in your face. Like, hey, I'm your daughter now. I mean, some of us are. I've been that way a couple times. Most of them just want to know that you still love them. And that you'll be there, because that's what I want. Now I'm trying to cry really bad. Okay. I have some actual public speaking experience and was a teacher, so I'm a little bit better at keeping myself together. The best thing you can do is, if you have a transgender child, is get informed. If you came here looking for that, then you've taken a step in the right direction, I guess. I'll probably go ahead and actually link the Wikipedia article for transgender stuff, like, in the description for once, so that if you want more information, that's a good start. If you want to go back and look at some of my older videos, it does come up, but it's too sporadic to say anything. Another thing you can do is just stay here on YouTube and just enter in the search, being transgender. And there's more and more of us just publicly being out and trying to help, because it's a big issue, and it seems like more and more. I know it's probably not more and more than it actually was, it's just, it seems like it is, just like with, like, terrorism and economic issues, with everything, it's just more and more instantaneous media, basically. Everybody knows everything that's going on all the time, as opposed to you only knew what was going on in your little part of the world back then. It seems more and more like kids are wanting to be transgender, and it's not that they want to be transgender, it's that they are. And it's important for them to even know what that means, much less yourself or anybody else, just because it's a huge step to want to try to move toward that, and it's, a lot of it is irreversible. You will always hear the arguments and cases that, well, this transgender person did it and decided they weren't transgender and then had to go back. It's like, well, okay, good for them. It sucks, but it does happen sometimes, just like I like using this example from a video I just did. I like candy, so I tried the candy. I do not like this candy, so I'm done with it. Unfortunately, it is kind of like that. You can know something and want something, and then you get to the experience of it and it can just be like too hard for you, or it wasn't what you were expecting. So more than anything, it's better to know the limits of what you're trying to do and set appropriate expectations. A lot of transgender people, unless they start like really young on hormones, come out pretty bass ugly, honestly. Hormones always affect people differently. Like for me, it's not gonna do a whole lot like anymore for like my face. I'm not gonna show up on YouTube one day and be like looking like supermodel. I'm pretty much kinda at the limit of what hormones are gonna do for me. And for some people, it can actually have adverse effects, and that's important to look into as well. Counterindications, contraindications, Matt will correct me, I'm sure. Where you can take testosterone blockers, and they have the opposite effect. And that's not something you want when you're transgender. So it's important to weigh the risks and benefits, set proper expectations, and know the limits of what you're trying to do. I mean, for 99% of cases, at the very minimum, hormones will do nothing for facial hair. They didn't do shit for mine. And if I don't shave for even like a day, it is really gross. So something like that to consider. One of the things as well is a lot of transgender people, even older ones, expect very prominent results from being on hormones. Like they think after a couple of years you're going to be like super curvy and have big breasts, and that is not the case most of the time. Like for one thing, the basis is usually go with your family history, like for breasts. You will never, with very rare exception, end up having as large breasts as the female members of your family. That's just how it works. I actually ended up bigger, which is probably a bit embarrassing for a couple of people. And just stuff like that. It's not some magic cure. It's not gonna just make you a woman. It's actually a joke I have with Matt every once in a while. I'm like, if I take all my hormone pills at once, I'll grow ovaries, right? And he's just like, no. And I'm just like, I'm kidding, sweetie. And it's just, it would be a pleasant thought to have if that was true, but I know it can't happen. But yeah, if you came here looking for information, I hope I was helpful in some way. I'll have a couple links in the description with more information, Wikipedia articles, and some of the more prominent websites that you're going to find either way. They're here if you want them. And don't ever accept a generalized experience of being transgender. Like I said, my experience and what I've said isn't going to be the same as for anybody else, probably 95% of the time. And then of course there's even just differences in where you live. Make sure that what you're looking at is for where you live, because it's a pretty big thing in the United States. Where in Colorado, I had medical care for everything. I had hormones. I could have gotten any medical procedures that I wanted, no problem. And oddly enough, I'm actually finding it a little harder to do here in Massachusetts than anything else. And it was just impossible in Texas. So just something to keep in mind when it comes to knowing what's going on, especially if it's happening to yourself or your children, or somebody you know, whatever. Keep in mind where they live, because it's going to be a pretty big issue. And then, of course, just be there for them. That's all they really want. I hope I was helpful. Links in the description. Leave me a like. If you watch this whole thing, I got nothing better to do. Thank you for watching. So long.